Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Urban Libertarian here, and thanks for tuning in. And also, hey, thanks. I got over 100 subscribers, so wow, I guess that's an accomplishment. Cool. For those of you who actually like my content or put up with it, thank you. I appreciate it. For those of you who are like trolls, paid trolls or not, you can screw off. You might as well just please just unsubscribe because I don't buy subscribers. I'm not even, obviously I'm not in it for the money, so that's cool. That's just a side note, so interesting. A lot of breaking news. I was gonna make a video about a bunch of other stuff dealing with CNN, but this just seems to me really important. I'll make this as quick as I can. So apparently there's been Stingray devices, eavesdropping devices called Stingray devices found near Washington, D.C. and the White House. And the point of this video is CNN, surprisingly, it's CNN that's reporting it, but they blame Trump, of course. It's Trump's fault, right? But I think they missed the whole point of the story is that they're not concerned about us. So let's just watch this.
Tonight, we have new details about electronic spying devices showing up in very suspicious places, including right near the White House. Let's bring in CNN's Brian Todd. Brian, what kind of threat do these listening devices pose, and do we have any idea who might be responsible for planting them?
Wolf, intelligence experts and members of Congress say that
I'm just sorry, I love. Do we have any idea who might have planted them? Of course we do. We know.
They believe foreign intelligence agencies could be planting these devices. Now, this has real urgency.
Now, they think there's foreign intelligence agencies, and if you watch this report and you have a critical mind, I'll show to you why I think it's actually someone, group or something, or it could just be a private group, but I don't think it may not be a foreign actor. Watch this. You'll see why. I'll explain it.
See tonight because President Trump, according to multiple sources, has been using his personal cell phone more and more often in recent weeks to contact outside advisors. One senior White House official telling CNN he's, quote, talking to all sorts of people on it. Tonight, new information suggests that those calls.
I will say that's not a good idea.
Calls could be more vulnerable to being spied on. A new report from the Department of Homeland Security says there were signs that cell phone surveillance devices were detected as recently as last year, operating near the White House and other sensitive locations around Washington. The devices are called Stingrays, or International Mobile Subscriber Identity Catchers, and they're not only illegal for non-law enforcement usage in America, they're capable of gathering a lot of secret information.
Okay, so they're illegal for non-law enforcement usage, right? So just pay attention.
The IMSI catcher pretends that it's a cell phone tower, so your phone will connect to it and it will collect things like the device number so it knows who you are, records of who you communicate with, and in some instances.
Right, okay, so it collects a bunch of information because I don't want.
Now,
this is fair use,
members
by the
of
way.
Congress
so I'm just
and analysts
commenting.
Say they were likely planted by spies.
The only people that could do this and get away with it are people under diplomatic cover, which means foreign intelligence services. It could be China. It could be Russia.
Former.
See, this is where I disagree, and I totally disagree. It could be some anti-Trump group. It could just be, I mean, it's a device. There's the internet, there's cash, there's the dark web or whatever. It's not hard to buy things, right? So maybe one of these things got out, and somebody, some rogue group like you see in the movies, like in Die Hard, right? A group of Germans wearing jackets. Leather jackets have hijacked, have bought one of these things, right? With some, I don't know, whatever, some group from the Middle East or whatever, right? I don't know, but I mean, it could be someone within our own intelligence agencies going rogue. It could be somebody within the United States with a lot of money going rogue. Who knows? But I think it's. If you keep watching this, I'll show you the point where I think it's actually they know the government knows whoever some agency who the agency who overwatches this, I guess, over Homeland Security, they must know because you'll see they say that's okay.
CIA officer Bob Baer says there's also spy software called SS7.
Okay, it gets even more information,
even more
right?
Content
there we
than
go.
Stingray.
Okay.
Send introduce.
And I'm going to get into the Stingrays. You know, I'm just going to get into it now. So while you're watching, so these were used against us. Okay, this is KPCC 89.3 FM. If you're ever in the Los Angeles or Pasadena area, I board opted there for a little bit. A good station, where they're in Pasadena. But anyway, they're very liberal, by the way. And they did. I mean, there's more news on this too, by the way. But LAPD used a dirt box, so it's worse than a Stingray, and they spied on people. Okay, I'm not going to get into it. So yeah, and then here's another one from was this Mike. I think this was from BuzzFeed, but there's links to Mike, which is, I think they're related, talking about, is there an FBI plane circling you? Yeah, BuzzFeed here, there's a map. So, I mean, these are all liberal publications. It's not a conspiracy theory. So we're being violated, and I don't see the media freaking out. And you should. This isn't right. This is total violations of our rights. All of these spying devices, right? So you'll see what happens. Like why it's dangerous, right? Why Apple could buy one of these things and spy on Microsoft, for example.
Where into the phone, which then will bleed off.
Okay, so it talks about how it works. Blah, blah, blah.
Experts say all of this technology capable of intercepting calls is why they're concerned about reports that President Trump is using a personal mobile phone inside the White House.
But they're not concerned that. What about regular people? What about all the, this was a 2000, this is a 2005 article, okay, from the LAPD bought these stupid things in 2005 from the Department of Homeland Security. They're the ones giving it out. The Department of Homeland Security is the ones that giving these things out.
They say even if he isn't discussing top secret information, he could still.
To spy on you.
He'll be creating a security risk.
Whether it's him trying to get around John Kelly by using this cell phone, and someone could ask, well, what's Kelly going to think? And if he responds, well, it doesn't matter, he's at the Pentagon right now. That's not classified, but that can tell foreign intelligence agencies, the chief of staff of the White House.
And anything you could say just like
White
that.
House is meeting with people.
Is completely vulnerable to having his conversations. The president is completely vulnerable.
So what he's going to say, just switch the president and put you.
Bayer says drastic measures might be needed to protect the president.
You. To protect you. Drastic measures might be needed to protect you from illegal spying.
It's conversations.
Look, the president is
you.
Completely vulnerable to having his conversation.
Your conversation.
Just listen to. I would take his phone away from him.
We should all have our phones taken
There's
away.
No way to secure it.
There's no way to secure your
votes.
The Democratic
votes, so there Senator Ron Wyden of the Intelligence Committee and other members of Congress have called on the Federal Communications Commission.
And here's the point where they say, hey, FCC, look into this. And here we go. Look.
To investigate the use of those interception devices. So far, the FCC has resisted that, saying it has no particular evidence that the devices are being unlawfully used.
Okay. Let's see if he says anything else.
We've reached out to the White House, but they've not responded to the concerns over the.
Okay. Listen to that again, okay?
Has resisted that, saying it has no particular evidence that the devices are being unlawfully used.
So remember, they can only be used by what? By lawful, like federal agents, essentially, or police, right? In the United States. So they're saying there's no evidence that it's not our guys using it. So there you go, CNN. You just answered your own question. That's all I'm going to spin on this, but the story, it's a very big story. But I think the story that's getting missed and people aren't going to talk about is that you're the ones getting spied upon and your communications are not safe. And that is wrong in this country. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think.